In a booklet that came with the Tarantino Connection, a collection of soundtrack songs from his films, Tarantino says, "One of the things I do when I'm writing a movie or when I have an idea for a film is I go through my record collection and just start playing songs, trying to find the personality of the movie, find the spirit of the movie. Then boom, eventually I'll hit one or two or three songs or one song in particular. Oh, this will be a great opening credit song." Tarantino continued, "To me, the opening credits are very important because that's the only mood time that most movies give themselves. A cool credit sequence and the music that plays in front of it, or note played, or any music, whatever you decide to do, that sets the tone for the movie that's important for you. So I'm always trying to find what the right opening or closing credit should be early on when I'm just even thinking about the story. Once I find it, that really kind of triggers me to what the personality of the piece should be, what the rhythm of this piece should be." In today's episode, I'd like to analyze the theme song of The Sopranos, Woke Up This Morning by Alabama 3, in an attempt to dissect the creative process that authors like Quentin Tarantino and David Chase deploy to ideate amazing films and TV shows. Let's take a look. You woke up this morning, got yourself a gun. As a member of the Italian mob in New Jersey, it would be fair to assume that Tony would arm himself first thing in the morning. Most guys in the show probably do. But Tony prefers the newspaper first thing in the morning. As a leader of a family, he understands the importance of information at the turn of the century. But in the context of the show, this verse represents Tony's point of view of looking at himself and his colleagues as soldiers in a war, and every soldier has to arm himself with an appropriate weapon. However, Tony isn't someone who shies away from arming himself with a firearm should the situation demand it. Mama always said, "You'd be the chosen one." This line is ironic because in the show, Livia Soprano doesn't believe in her son's capacity of being a leader, even though Tony actually exhibits every quality of being one. Tony is doomed to be underestimated by every single elder in the show except Polly Walnuts, even though he's actually a great leader. However, she credits herself for raising Tony, pointing to his mansion on the hill as a benchmark of her successful parenting. She said, "You're one in a million." Being one in a million means that you are special, even though statistically, there are almost 7,500 people like you around the world. This verse points to an interesting observation about Tony, which is that he's special in certain ways. He's more successful than both his father and uncle were at his age. He's the leader of the family. He basically controls all organized crimes in New Jersey and enjoys all the spoils that his position has to offer. But in other ways, he's quite an ordinary man. He has an unhappy marriage, he cheats on his wife, he has depression, he has anxiety, his job is stressful, his mother is overbearing, he's worried about his children's safety and his family's future. You've got to burn to shine. Success requires sacrifice. Tony's lifestyle has its perks. He reports to a strip club for work. He has tremendous wealth and the support of his soldiers. He can buy expensive jewelry for both his wife and his guma. Most of the time, he has access to free stuff. He has a boat, a mansion, political and underworld connections. All this without doing any labor or dirtying his hands directly. Life is comfortable for Tony, but being the boss comes at a price. Tony's always looking over his shoulder, evading law enforcement, crushing rival families, quelling dissent within the soldiers, as well as resolving unrest within his own homes throughout the show. While the life of a mafioso is definitely alluring on the surface, one is left to wonder whether the sacrifices are worth it. But you are born under a bad sign with a blue moon in your eyes. This verse builds directly on the message of the previous verse. A blue moon curse originates from the Italian folklore. To be born under a bad sign is first to be cursed, with the phrase blue moon in your eyes solidifying that this person is cursed and hence cannot lead a good or pure life. This line speaks to the cursed nature of Tony's life. Over the course of this show, we see Tony's mother and uncle conspire to kill him, his sister conspire with Richie Aprile to kill him and replace him as boss of the family. We also see Tony making painful decisions like killing his cousin Tony B, Jackie Aprile Jr., Pussy Bompensero, and his nephew Christopher. Even Artie, his best friend, describes him like a predator, even though Tony tries his best to protect him from the fallout of his bad decisions. You woke up this morning, all that love had gone. This is a recurring pattern in Tony's life. Throughout the show, we see Tony fall in and out of love with various people, be it family members like his mother, his sister, his uncle Junior, his nephew Christopher, and cousin Tony B, or business associates like Ralph Cifarato, Phil Leotardo, Vito, or his gumas like Gloria Trillo, Irina, Valentina, or his childhood friend Artie. Your papa never told you about right and wrong. Tony's father had a tremendous impact on Tony's sense of morality. Johnny Soprano had a do as I say, not as I do approach to parenting, which permanently skewed Tony's sense of morality. Tony once witnessed Johnny cut the pinky finger off of Mr. Satriali. While Johnny criticized him for walking in on the scene, he also praised him for not freaking out about it. One can understand where Tony's appreciation for Gary Cooper stems from. While Tony's father definitely told him what's right and wrong, the definition of morality can be very different when your father is a narcissist. But you're looking good, baby. I believe you're feeling fine. Shame about it. This verse reminded me about a line from American Psycho.
Because I want to fit in.
With this line, we are finally confronted with the depression of Tony Soprano. Tony fits into his role as a mafiosi, and seemingly everything seems to be going okay for him on the surface. He's rich, married to a beautiful woman, has two healthy children, visits his mother, business is good. On the surface, there doesn't seem to be any concrete reason for him to be depressed. Notice the usage of the word believe to the onlooker. Tony seems to be feeling fine, but that is clearly not the case as asserted by the words shame about it.
Still, I gotta be the sad clown for my friends, my family, and on brave front.
You woke up this morning, the world turned upside down. Lord above, things ain't been the same since the blues walked into town. This stanza could be interpreted in two ways, and both seem to be relevant to the show. The first way of interpreting these lines would be in the context of Tony's depression. The show deals with issues that Tony faces in his life, particularly in the context of his depression coming in the way of his work and personal life. For the ordinary civilian, seeking mental health care would be encouraged. But in the world of Tony Soprano, this is looked upon as a sign of weakness and as a sign of betrayal of the vows of the Omerta. Tony faces an assassination attempt when news about his meetings with a psychiatrist leaks out, and certain people in his circle even see it as a sign of weakness throughout the show. The second way of interpreting these lines would be in the context of law enforcement's attention on Tony and his associates, particularly in their use of the RICO predicate to indict and convict mob figures. Running an organized crime family in this day and age has become exceedingly challenging as boss of the family. The old values of Omerta that kept them safe from law enforcement don't seem to be working anymore, and Tony faces unprecedented amounts of pressure as he tries to run a family without getting killed or put in prison. Either way, things haven't been the same since the blues walked into town. But you're one in a million, you've got that shotgun shine. Shame about it. Born under a bad sign with a blue moon in your eyes. These lines can be interpreted in two contexts. Firstly, in the context of Tony's attractiveness to women. Secondly, in the context of Tony's attractiveness in the field of business. Tony's persona as a leader and a conventional man makes it relatively easy for him to attract women. Throughout the show, we see women get attracted to him easily. His wife, his gumas, his psychiatrist are all attracted to him. However, loving Tony is no cakewalk. The show explores the ways having a relationship with Tony has adversely affected the women who are attracted to him. Gloria Trillo becomes obsessed with Tony to the point where his rejection of her advances leads her to suicide. Marriage to Tony has led Carmela to confront her guilt in the ways he earns his money, as well as her loss of agency that comes with being his wife. Valentina ends up in the burn ward, and Jennifer Melfi herself ends up seeking therapy while attempting to cure Tony's anxiety issues with talk therapy.
That is the scariest man I have ever been attracted to.
Similarly, Tony's position in the mob world makes him attractive to various men, all of whom end up either dead, like Bobby Bacala, Tony V, Richie Aprile, Jackie Jr., Christopher Moltisanti, or devastated, like Dave Scatino. Beware, Tony might be attractive, but he's also deadly. The word shotgun shine is a simplification or a symbolism of this concept and a way of saying that a person has a killer instinct, however attractive they may be. We can clearly see how well Alabama 3's Woke Up This Morning represents Tony Soprano. What's an opening theme song that you think perfectly describes the setting or the characters of a show? Let me know in the comments.